You know, America's got a whole lot of challenges. And so my response then continues to be what I believe today, which is Russia's actions are a problem. They don't pose the number one national security threat to the United States. I continue to be much more concerned when it comes to our security with the prospect of a nuclear weapon going off in Manhattan.
A nuclear weapon going off in Manhattan.
Here's the other side of the $100 bill. I'm going to enlarge it. There you go. This is all water splashing up. This is a missile right here. There are the fins of the missile. Here's the fuselage of the missile and the head of the missile impacting into the water. This ink represents the water going up and a nuke. Watch as I change the magnification. Ready? There it is. See the different layers of ink? Watch what there's the missile hitting. There it is going in. There's the water coming up and the nuke beginning. There it is. All right, also on this bill, there's this blue stripe. It's a hologram. What it is, it's, if I move it around, it's the Liberty Bell and it's ringing. If you move a hologram, the hologram moves. So if there was a clanger in there and it's going like this, what would it be doing? It would be going ding, 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 ding. They are sounding their alarm. This bill is a vehicle to distribute their plans. That's what they're doing. These are their plans to nuke the United States. It's Satan's plan, by the way, Satan and the fallen angels. But we have members of our government who have been taken over by demonic spirits, and they're part of this.
Taylor Momsen, one of the stars of the teenage drama Gossip Girl, is also the lead singer of a rock band called The Pretty Reckless, whose new music video, Heaven Knows, features her putting out cigarette butts on the Bible, burning them, and committing other acts of anti-Christian blasphemy. Taylor Momsen got her start in the entertainment industry years ago as the little, sweet, and innocent Cindy Lou Who in the film version of The Grinch Who Stole Christmas. But later, as she grew up, changed her image to that of a literal satanic promoting puppet. Seen here wearing a shirt that reads, "She will bleep you for Satan." That's right, guys, she'll bang you for Satan. One of her previous songs, titled Kill Me, which promotes suicide, also promotes snorting crystal meth. It's not bad enough, apparently, for Miley Cyrus to be promoting cocaine and ecstasy to her largely preteen fan base of impressionable millennials. But Taylor Momsen now sings, blowing guys in the back seats of cars and snorting crystal meth. With a wink and a smile and a vial of meth, she sings, "She took his hand and walked through the shadow of death." It's quite clear that the video, Heaven Knows, is anti-Christian blasphemy. But, you know, you won't hear anything in the mainstream media denouncing Taylor Momsen for doing this. There's Jesus making out with a woman to the right here on this television. You can clearly see this popular piece of religious art that symbolizes God reaching down to man. Here is the Bible that, instead of saying the good book, they changed it to say the good fool. There with a church on the right-hand side. At the end of the music video, a bunch of, just 7-year-old kids are worshiping at the feet of this satanic singing servant who smells like a sewer. What's particularly interesting is while it's a sport to blaspheme Jesus, to be an anti-Christian bigot in the mainstream media in Hollywood, it's incredible the double standard, how you shouldn't dare. Your career will be killed if you dare criticize a particular theocratic country for their human rights violations. But it's a sport, it's a promotional tool to blaspheme Jesus, to put cigarette butts out on the Bible in your music videos, to have 7- and 8-year-old children in your videos burning the Bible as this crystal meth promoting, suicide urging, sick and twisted servant of Satan, Taylor Momsen, who will bang guys for the devil, promotes.
James Boyd was shot last weekend at the end of a 3-hour altercation with police. They said he didn't have the right to camp there. The officers say they repeatedly told Boyd to get on the ground and ultimately fired 6 shots, killing him.
Could you send an officer over here? We have a son that has schizophrenia, and he's not doing very good, but we got to get him someplace.
That was Vidal's stepfather calling 911. He told the dispatcher this had happened before, and all they wanted was help getting him to treatment. 2 officers from 2 different departments responded, and family members say everything seemed under control. Officers calmly talked with their son. He wasn't violent. That's when they say a 3rd officer showed up and ordered the 2 others to shoot Keith Vidal with stun guns. Seconds later, that same officer shot and killed him.
They murdered our son for no reason.
A family friend who had known Keith for years shared details with CNN iReport, describing how the 5'3", 100-pound teen fell when he was stunned. How 2 officers then jumped on top of him. And while they held him down, the 3rd officer, who ordered the stun guns, then shot Keith in the chest and killed him.
See this kid? This is my son. This is my flesh and blood that they murdered.
The teen's family and friends angrily demand action against the officer. The district attorney promises to go wherever the truth leads.
David Mattingly joins us. Now, David, what's the status right now on the 3 officers who were involved in this incident?
That once the state has finished with its investigation, then everyone will find out that all of these officers were acting appropriately.
Then everyone will find out that all of these officers were acting appropriately.
Will be to develop an overall strategy for America in this period when really a new world order can be created. It's a great opportunity, and it's just a crisis.
We know the race is not to the swift, nor the battle to the strong. Do you not think an angel rides in the whirlwind and directs this storm?
I do have one question. During the crisis, or any time that you're aware of, has the Federal Reserve or Treasury participated in any gold swaps arrangements?
The Federal Reserve does not own any gold at all. We have not owned gold since 1934.
Congress shall now vote for approval of H.R. 8791, the Homeland Terrorism Preparedness Bill. Said bill requests emergency response funding up to and including... I'm sorry, this section is classified.
Which passages of Scripture should guide our public policy? Should we go with Leviticus, which suggests slavery is okay, and that eating shellfish is an abomination? Or we could go with Deuteronomy, which suggests stoning your child if he strays from the faith? Or should we just stick to the Sermon on the Mount, a passage that is so radical that it's doubtful that our own Defense Department would survive its application?
Evil men have already divided up the world into regions, and they've got it all planned. They want to rule the world. Their goal is to reduce the population to a half billion, with a few of them as the right, you know, the elite get to rule the world. God has plans for the world, and so does Satan. And Satan's plan is no people here, maybe just a few, and a one-world government. The Bible says perilous times shall come. The people will be fierce, despisers of those that are good. Christians are going to be absolutely hated.
I want to tell you about a few of the things that I have learned during these last 5 years of intensive research. Perhaps the most startling thing that I can share with you is that all of the conspiracy theories that you've ever heard about one world government, about the UN takeover of the world, all of those conspiracies have now been laid to rest. There's nothing conspiratorial about it. It's all published. The UN-funded Commission on Global Governance began meeting in 1992 in earnest and met for 4 years, and last fall released their final report. It is entitled Our Global Neighborhood.
Are we the last generation? Lord, let it be made known to the people who have been acting up, who've been doubting, who've been trying to wrestle with you, because we can't be playing in this final hour, because eternity is forever. Eternity is forever. You can't be playing in this final hour because they're not playing. The globalists are not playing. The elites are not playing. The New World Order system is not playing. Satan knows he has but a short time. And God knows that the day of the Lord is at hand. I hope you're saved.
As we move forward, anytime you come closer to something, your vision should get clearer. Am I right? You are a tool in the hidden hand that's using you. Please don't be delusional. The rulers of this world practice confusing you. The people and the priests and the imams have been jammed by government scams. Mind systematically programmed. Blatant black hatred and racism. The way they lace the whole world and nation with traces of Satanism. This place is a pagan prison. The founding fathers' enslaving intentions were no different than Bush's and Reagan's visions. 1776, it took action. This Illuminati took form and was spawned from a Colombian faction. Just flip your $1 bill over. And if you want me to expose the true code of deception, I will show you. We live in a designed wicked system. The number 13 is consistent in Masonic symbolism. It represents transformation. 12 completes a cycle, so 13 was rebirth and regeneration. The meanings of the symbol are strategically hid. On the left side, you see a 13-layered pyramid. Over that, sits the all-seeing eye where the light shines. A sign of the devil watching over you at all times. With the words Anuit Coeptis, 13 letters meaning he has favored our undertakings. Will you accept this? Or will you learn the science and ignore them? Under the pyramid you see Novus Ordo Seclorum. Translated, new order of the world, or the new world order. Authors and satanic fathers of mass slaughter. The eagle that you see on the right sits below 13 stars with a shield that has 13 stripes. And an olive branch in its claws with 13 leaves, which is supposed to be in its talent to represent peace. But peace was always on a decrease. His other claw holds 13 arrows of war, set to be released, and the letters at the bottom of the pyramid are fixed with the Roman numerals that equals 1776. The United States of America exists in a deep devilish abyss where truth and paganism mix. Every president that ever lived was foul. They gather at Bohemian Grove where they bow down before the owl. See, the owl is wise and sees through the darkness of night. And there's a small one on the dollar near the one on the top right. It ain't hard to understand this government was never for us. The eagle was based off of the Egyptian hawk Horus. The 13 colonies who went to wicked sovereignty and made no apology for the obvious idolatry. Subconsciously, we follow the ways of the beast and pay homage to pagan gods when we say days of the week. Like Sunday, they worship the sun. Monday is moon day. Tyr, the god of war, was worshipped on Tuesday. Odin, the chief god, is who Wednesday is named for. Thursday is Thursday, god of thunder, the mighty Thor. Friday was named after Frigga. Notice the pattern. Saturday is the Roman god of agriculture, Saturn. Frigga was the goddess of love, the wife of Odin. The polytheistic theologies needed decoding. The rituals, like trips across the sand as man takes. The skull and bones fraternity, the secret handshakes. But understand, he receives only 33 degrees. He secretly believes in Lucifer and other deities. Many powerful and rich people are controlled by these. They even hold
the soul of several of your favorite MCs. Politicians telling lies, tongues riddled with thorns, and use hand gestures shaped in the form of devil horns. You don't feel this any harm because you don't know what it entails. Satan tampers with stem cells and sprays chemtrails. The so-called holidays are hypocrisy, established to use religious doctrines to commit annual robbery. Christmas split in half is Christ's mass. The so-called birth of Jesus, where every home has glowing lights cast. Christ the anointed one masked the birth celebration, but Jesus' birth was kept secret due to the situation. The king initiated a death plot because the Messiah was prophesied to rule, so Jesus' murder was authorized. No one knows the actual date. That's why sometimes you see Xmas. X means unknown, but ignorance affects us. A fraud that was purposely flawed. December 25th, the birthday of the wicked ruler Nimrod. This whole disguise is part of Satan's universal rise. A holy prophet's life being pimped and commercialized. Traditions like lights on trees, rooted in the Nicene Council in 325 AD. By Constantine, these matters were decreed. The concept of a virgin birth was actually conceived and then agreed. With graven images in the temple, the fish on your car is called Onis, a Babylonian symbol. It's visibly contradictory, telling your children lies. You need to make them study Santa Claus's sick history. But yet we go wherever Satan leads us. The falsehoods we practice in his name ain't got nothing to do with Jesus.
Yeah, yeah.
Folks, you're looking at the four blood moons. This is going to be the eighth blood moon, four blood moon tetra on Jewish feast days since the crucifixion of Christ. Matter of fact, you're looking at the first one right there, April 14th of 32 AD, 1-2. The third one, you see the cross, that happened on, of course, April the 3rd. 33 AD, when the three crosses on a hill far away was a 33-year-old son of God who gave his life for the sins of the world. That was also the third of four blood moons and a total solar eclipse of the sun, that Christ died on the cross, and there was a major earthquake that hit the same day, and many bodies of the saints were seen walking in the streets of Jerusalem after the resurrection.